Hi everyone, welcome to Mathematically Inclined.
Now there are multiple methods to find inverse of a matrix. One of them we'll be covering today is elementary transformations. It is further subdivided under two categories, E row and E column. That means elementary row operations and elementary column operations. So let's see how we take them one by one.
On the YouTube search bar, you can type for Neha Agarwal Maths or Mathematically Inclined. That will lead you to my channel. You can click on the playlist. Here you will be able to find different chapters. For example, you want to watch continuity, you can click on that. This opens all the subtopics in the chapter for you. You can click on the video of your choice.
Hi everyone!
And get started. Also, when you open the description box, you would find the link to my channel. You can directly click on that and follow the same procedure.
Beginning with invertible matrices, now if we have A to be a square matrix of order n, and if there exists another matrix B of the same order n, then in that case, if AB is the same as BA, is giving us the unit matrix. That means we need to understand that in this case, AB and BA, they commute and both of them are giving us the identity matrix. Then we say this B is A inverse. Let's try and understand the three valid row or column transformations that we would apply. The first one says interchanging two rows or column. That means, for instance, we have a matrix, let's say, which is 2 cross 2, or we can have 3 cross 3. In that case, interchanging any two rows, maybe we are doing row 1 gets interchanged with row 2, or row 2 gets interchanged with row 3, or row 1 gets interchanged with row 3. Any of them is possible. Point number 2, which is multiplying all elements of a row or a column by a non-zero scalar. That means we can apply Ri is k times some Ri. So this is scalar multiplication, or let's say column I is the same as some non-zero scalar L times column I. So in short, scalar multiplication of elements of a specific row or a column. Third, adding to the elements of a row or a column the corresponding elements of any other row or column multiplied with a scalar. This appears to be a bit confusing. Let's say we take an example of a 2 cross 2 matrix. Then in this case, multiplied by a scalar and we add, so I can write it as row 1 is say row 1 plus twice of row 2. So what happens now is, if I have to transform my elements of the first row, then this 2 becomes 2 plus twice of the corresponding element of the second row, so twice of 0. So 2 stays 2. For minus 1, we would have minus 1 plus twice of the corresponding element, which is 3. So this makes it 5. Please have a glance at all three properties once again. Now, before we begin with the elementary row transformations, we need to understand the procedure briefly. So, first of all, we would write our matrix A as I into A. That means here I'll put my entire matrix. I'll write the identity matrix corresponding to it, and this A would be written as it is. Because by the theorem, whatever operations, whatever row operations we apply now would be valid only on the prefactor, that is I. So it will be valid on this A and this I. So this is how we are going to write it. The first thing, however, which we are going to check is, for A inverse to exist, determinant of A should be non-zero. Now, what is determinant of a square matrix and how is it calculated? Please refer to the short video on determinants. I'll be linking it to this video in the description box below. So once we have this format, Next on our agenda is to apply our valid row transformations to convert the first matrix into the unit matrix I. When you do that, the same operations would transform this I to a new matrix, let's say B, and this A is written as it is. This implies my B is the same as A inverse. So we are following what we are going to do for a row transformation. Now I'm revealing this secret to you as to how would you make this conversion. First for a 2 plus 2 matrix, then for a 3 cross 3 matrix. Please note these are the three valid operations that you can apply. However, in which format you apply, that is very important. So we are going to follow the pattern. First thing is, obviously you would have to ensure that if I call this matrix A, first thing you'll have to ensure is this is 1, because you are converting it into an identity matrix. Second, you would target this element, next is this, and lastly A12. So we are going to follow this pattern and you would see the procedure almost becomes mechanical. For a 3 cross 3 matrix, once again you will have to ensure A11 is 1, and after that you follow this pattern. Then you move here, then you come down again. If you remember this pattern, which would be probably this one. So if you remember this pattern and go about targeting each of the elements this way, that means this has to be 1, this should be 0, this should be 0 again. Then you would make this one 0. Basically, you're converting this to the identity matrix. Your procedure would be damn simple. So let's take an example to see how everything works for a 2 cross 2 matrix. For this question, the determinant of A is 2, which is not 0. Now, in order to begin, the first thing that we do for an elementary row transformation is express it as I into A. That could be written as the identity matrix of the same order into this A would be written as it is. Now, in order to start changing this matrix, we have to first see that the very first element becomes 1. In order to do that, either you can multiply both sides with half of row 1, or you can maybe subtract these two to create 1. It's completely your choice how you do that. So if we begin by saying let row 1 be row 1 minus row 2, so this matrix becomes 1, this becomes minus 6 plus 2, which is minus 4. 1 stays 1, minus 2 stays minus 2. This stays 1, this becomes minus 1, 0, 1, and A stays as it is. Next on our agenda is, please see, we would be proceeding this way. So next on our agenda is to make this 0, which would be simple. We can say row 2 is row 2 minus row 1. First row stays as it is, row 2 becomes 0, and minus 2 plus 4, that makes it just 2. Here once again, first row stays as it is, this becomes minus 1, and this is 1 minus minus 1, that's 2. Next, we are targeting this member 2. So we have to create this, we have to change this to 1. I can very conveniently do that by saying multiplying row 2 with half throughout. So this implies 1 minus 4, 0, 1 is equal to minus half, and 1 is equal to. So after applying the operation, this is what we get. Now we are only left with changing this to 0. So row 1 is row 1 plus 4 times row 2, which makes this as 1, 0, 0, 1. And here it becomes 1 minus 4 by 2, which is 1 minus 2, that's just minus 1. This becomes minus 1 plus 4, which is 3, minus half 1, and A as it is. So now, once you've got this, please do not leave your question here. and conclude by saying therefore A inverse is minus 1, 3, minus half and 1. Now moving on to a 3 cross 3 matrix, how to find its inverse? Once again, these are the valid operations and this is the procedure we are going to follow. So let's see. However, the first step that you are going to check is when you find determinant of A, for this matrix it turns out to be 25, not 0 implies A inverse exists. Now moving on to this one, please see we are going to follow this pattern. This is luckily already 1, so we are targeting minus 3 which is next in line. So we can say and then next would be 2. If you are comfortable applying 2 operations at a time, please do that. Else do them one by one stepwise. So I can write this as rho 2 is rho 2 plus thrice of rho 1, that will make this 0. And likewise rho 3 could be rho 3 minus twice of rho 1. So that means this matrix gets transformed to the first row stays as it is. Second one, this becomes 0. This would become 9. The next one makes it minus 5 plus, so this is minus 5 plus thrice of minus 2. So minus 5 plus thrice of minus 2 makes it minus 11. Coming to row 3, now once again the corresponding, it is row 3 minus twice of row 1 makes it 0. Next, once again, row 3 minus twice of row 1 makes it minus 1. Then 0 minus twice of minus 2, that makes it 4. Please ensure you apply the same operations to this identity matrix as well. So the first row stays as it is. The second one changes to 3, 1, 0. And next would be minus 2. 0 and 1. So once we've targeted these two elements, next on our agenda is this 9. How do we change this 9 to 1? Very simple. One thing is that you can multiply with 1 by 9. This will automatically give you 1. Another way is if you do not want to get into the fractions, then one of the ways which works perfectly over here is that your row 2 could be changed to row 2 plus 8 times row 3. Because the moment you do that, also one point to remember, once you have changed some element to 0 or 1, please, this procedure works well because it will not convert them back to any other element. So now moving on to this, row 2 is row 2 plus 8 times row 3. So this stays 0, this would give us 9 minus 8, that's 1, and minus 11 plus 8 times 4, that's minus 11 plus 32, that makes it 21. So this becomes 21. The third row was supposed to be the same. Similarly, on the right side, first and third row stay the same, and row 2 becomes, like see, 3 plus 8 times minus 2, that's 3 minus 16, which is minus 13. Next you have 1 plus 8 times 0, that makes it 1. Next you have 0 plus 8 times 1, that stays 8. Now we are targeting this element and making it 0. So your row 3 is simply row 3 plus row 2. So row 3 plus row 2 would be 0 here, 0 here, and 4 plus 21 makes it 25. Likewise, the first and the second rows, they stay as it is. So here the first, second rows stay as it is, third one changes. Here once again, first, second are the same. The third one becomes minus 2, minus 13, that's minus 15. This is 1, this is 9. Next on our agenda is to convert this to 1. So now this time we can apply the transformation that row 3 is 1 by 25 times row 3. And row 3 changes to 0, 0, 1. Similarly here the first two rows they stay as it is. And the last row, minus 15 upon 25 makes it minus 3 by 5. This would be 1 by 25. And this would be 9 by 25. And this A has to be copied as it is. So now we have worked through this one. Next on our target is to make this 0, which would be simply by saying row 2 is row 2 minus 21 times row 3. So this is 0, this stays 1, this becomes 0. Likewise, on the right side, the first and the third row, they stay as it is. And the second row, please see, this will be minus 13 minus 21 times the corresponding element, which is minus 3 by 5. So once I take the LCM, this is like saying minus 65 plus 63 by 5. So the answer is minus 2 by 5. Similarly, for the next element, it will be 1 minus 21 by 25. So once you take the LCM, this is just 4 by 25. And now for 8, you would have 8 minus 21 times 9 by 25. So once you take the LCM, this is 200. This is 189 by 25, which makes it 11 by 25. Now moving further, this time we are targeting this to become 0 and next would be this one. So in order to make your row minus 2 as 0, please see whatever rows we are using, we have to ensure that none of the already made 0 or 1 elements get back to any other element. So your row 1 you can say is row 1 plus twice of row 3, because that will not affect the other two elements in the row. So this makes it 1, 3, this becomes minus 2 plus twice of 1, which is 0, and the remaining two rows stay as they were. Likewise, for the first row, like this one becomes 1 plus twice of minus 3 by 5. So 1 plus twice of minus 3 by 5. Once you take the LCM, you get minus 1 by 5. Next, it is 0 plus twice of this. So this is simply 2 by 25. Next, it is 0 plus twice of row 3. So which makes it 18 by 25 here. Next two rows are to be copied as they were. Now we are only left to convert this to 0, which could be very conveniently done with the second row. So your row 1 is row 1 minus thrice of row 2, because that will not affect the remaining two elements. And this becomes perfect. We've got our identity matrix. And here, so the first element we have minus 1 by 5 minus 3 times minus 2 by 5, that makes it minus 1 plus 6, so 5 by 5 makes it 1. For the next element, we would have 2 by 25 minus thrice of 4 by 25, that makes it minus 10 by 25, which is minus 2 by 5. Likewise, for the third element, it would be 18 by 25 minus 3 times 11 by 25. So that makes it 18 minus 33 by 25. It would be minus 15 by 25, which is minus 3 by 5. And the remaining elements we copy as they were. So now we have converted our initial matrix into identity. This is our new matrix, which becomes the inverse. So as earlier, you would conclude your answer by saying, therefore, A inverse is this. Please have a look at the entire question once again. And for further questions, you would once again follow this pattern. This brings us to the end of this video. I hope you all understood how to apply the elementary row transformations. If you want me to take up any more questions on this topic, please leave the comment below. I would see you with elementary column transformations. Until then, bye-bye.